Have you ever held a Bible and felt overwhelmed at the thought of reading it? Or maybe you've spent time reading it, but it didn't seem to make sense. If that's you, then you're at the right place. Hello, my name is David Spivey, and today I want to share with you a few tips that will help you read the Bible in a meaningful, even transformational way. So stay tuned. The Bible is a book like no other, literally like no other. It's a collection of 66 individual books written in three languages by over 40 authors on three different continents over a span of more than 1,500 years. There is no other book in the world that does that. But what makes it miraculous is that all of these books tell one story. The story of a holy God who is lovingly seeking to redeem his fallen creation through the person of his Son, Jesus Christ. Because the Bible recounts this redemptive storyline, reading your Bible is one of the most important aspects of being a Christian. The Bible is the primary way we begin to know who this God is and what he wants to do in and through us. 1 Peter 2:2 encourages believers to desire the sincere milk of the Word that we may grow thereby. And Hebrews 4 emphasizes that the Word of God is alive and has the power to transform lives, as millions of people, including myself, can testify. If this is true, then I'm sure you would agree that it's critically important that we consistently and diligently read, study, and obey this life-altering book. Hopefully I've established that a believer should read his Bible, but you may ask, does it matter when I read my Bible? Well, yes and no. Thankfully, you can read and these days listen to your Bible anytime, anywhere. But if you're like me, you found that a failure to plan a specific time to read the Bible is likely a plan to fail to read the Bible at all. For most of us, reading God's Word first thing in the morning is the most profitable, helping us set the tone for our day. Of course, one size never fits all. Some night owls will do better reading in the evening when they aren't so groggy. The important thing is set a reading schedule and then don't allow yourself to be rushed or distracted during that time. Know that intentional effort and a consistent time will facilitate God speaking to you through His Word. For the Christian, there is only one Holy Bible. That being said, there are many different Bible versions or translations, and choosing the right one can be a daunting task. Because of the difference between the original languages and modern English, writing a translation that is accurate and easy to read is quite difficult. A good translator carefully aims for the balance of staying true to the original text, but expressing it in a manner that the reader can understand. To clarify, a more accurate translation can at times be more challenging to read, and an easier to read translation is usually less accurate. I would recommend reading a translation like the King James Version, and when you come across a passage that you don't understand, don't be afraid to ask a pastor or trusted spiritual advisor about the passage. Questions often lead to greater understanding. Just don't give up if the going gets tough. The Bible's still worth your read. It's important to realize that the Bible is not a collection of random sentences or verses, but rather it's a book telling one story, a story that spans God's redemptive plan over thousands of years. So when you read the Bible, recognize that each verse is connected to the verses around it, and together they communicate this grand narrative that a holy God so loved a sinful world that he sent his only Son to rescue and save it. It will make more sense if you read the Bible this way. It's also important to read the Bible personally. The Bible is not only a book addressed to the ancient Hebrew people and the surrounding nations, it's also a book that has personal application to our lives today. In other words, the Bible has a message for me and for you. So when you read the Bible, ask the Holy Spirit to reveal what He wants you to see in the Bible and how it should impact your life. Finally, it's important to read the Bible in community. While you may be by yourself when you are reading your Bible, you're not alone in reading the Bible. Millions of people, both past and present, have read the Bible and had God give them a deeper understanding of what it means. So learn from them. Whether a sermon, commentary, devotional, these tools can improve your understanding of God's Word through those around you. Revelation 1:3 says, "Blessed is he that readeth." When all is said and done, true blessing awaits those who both read and obey the Word of God. And I pray that this video has encouraged and challenged you to do just that. So let's start reading.